Romance and divine mercy. What in the world do those two things have to do with each other? You know, before going to seminary, I was really afraid I couldn't make it just because of how much of a hopeless romantic I was. I mean, I was endlessly going after different crushes and, man, like rom-coms and love music, all these things. I mean, I would be singing All of Me, John Legend, all the time in the shower, to the point where it was pretty annoying to my parents. Anyways, I ended up going to seminary, and while I was there, I remember going to one of my formators and talking to him about some issues I was facing in prayer. One, I didn't really know how to process my relationship with God, and two, I didn't really know how to process forgiveness for myself and from God in regards to my past. He offered me a few things. One, he taught me how to actually pray, and two, he offered me a few of his favorite books. While developing my prayer life, I also started to read these two books that he had given me. And man, they were super romantic. Both about like these guys that were hopelessly in love pursuing their beloved, regardless of all the suffering that they were facing. And I wondered to myself, why the heck does a celibate priest consider these romantic books to be some of his favorites? I also wondered, what does this have to do with my problems with God and my past? Funny enough, I eventually left seminary more of a romantic than I ever was, but in a much more purified way, because slowly but surely, the dots that were confusing me before were connected. I realized that this priest, and really all holy priests, must be romantics. Why? Because they're acting in the person of the ultimate romantic, Christ the bridegroom. When properly understood, we begin to see the Bible as just one gigantic love letter, the love letter of God to his people, the love letter of God to you. I mean, think about it. The entire story is about a lover pursuing his beloved despite how many times they mess up, to the point of even giving up his life for them. I mean, how much more romantic does it get than that? At the end of the day, all good love stories are simply reflections of this ultimate love story. And I realized then what these books, what these stories that this priest gave me had to do with my own problems with receiving God's love and healing. God's love is so crazy. And frankly, so scandalous, because no matter what you do, no matter what you've done, no matter what you've been through, he endlessly forgives you and heals you. And I think sometimes maybe we become numb to that, like we hear it, yeah, God loves you, yeah, God is merciful, but just think about this in your own life, right? Think about, you know, you have a spouse, you have a boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever it may be, and they're constantly unfaithful to you. They constantly do exactly what you tell them not to do. And yet, as soon as they come back to you, you forgive them. And you're not just coming back to you, you're going after them. And you're forgiving them. I mean, doesn't that sound irresponsibly loving? Who could do that but one who is madly in love? One who is constantly forgiving you. One who has the power to absorb everything that you have done, every wrong that you've done to him and to others, therefore to him, and take that onto himself and continue to love you, continue to heal you with no retribution. So this Divine Mercy Sunday, I challenge all of us to run back into the arms of the lover who is constantly pursuing us, the one who is awaiting us to simply ask for his mercy so he can pour it out unto us. Let's keep these words of Jesus to Saint Faustina in mind. My daughter, tell all people that I am love and mercy itself. When a soul approaches me with trust, I fill it with such an abundance of graces that it cannot contain within themselves, but it radiates them to other souls. Jesus, the merciful bridegroom, we trust in you.